the Chevy, I'm here now.
So hard, so bad.
Fuck it, if I break it, I pay for it. My lady's laying in the Chevrolet and
I like square body Chevys, but I ain't from the 80s. One day I'll drive a truck, next day a Mercedes.
Slowly slip into a pit, hanging on.
This is what we call the second annual Square Up for the Season food drive meet. We started as a club a couple years ago. We had done some car shows. We had done some camping trips, a lot of off-roading, get out in the mountains, just get away from it all and just be with, you know, like-minded people that have become like family. There's been some hard times in my life, man, and I like to recognize that and never forget where I came from and where I've gotten. I had a mom that passed at a young age of cancer, and I can remember growing up in the food banks because you don't have a lot when you're just making disability and you're raising a kid as your own on a single mom budget without much income to begin with. We were going out as a club and kind of doing and participating in some of these other events that were a good cause, charity causes, Toys for Tots, you know, other four-wheel drive events for different members of the community that maybe needed a little bit of help. But I hadn't started anything until last year, and I decided I wanted to do first annual Square Up for the Season. And I wanted to do it the weekend before Thanksgiving because in our economy, especially in Colorado, it's outrageous. Cost of living is so high. There's a lot of families, not just homeless, not just people that, you know, are down on their luck, but there's a lot of families, hardworking families, that have started to struggle even with two incomes. Some people work their asses off. Some people have a house that they own. Some people have nice cars. But they over budget and you end up where it's tough to put food on the table in certain instances. So last year I decided we were gonna do this meet and it was gonna be a food drive meet, and I wanted to pack as much food into the local food banks as we could right before Thanksgiving. And that way everybody, I don't care who you are, you could be the dude sleeping under the tree over by the RTD, you could be the guy that has two cars and a wife and three kids, that's not for us to decide, but in my opinion, everybody deserves to eat on Thanksgiving. I don't care who you are, you deserve to fucking eat and not be hungry. Everybody would, you know, typically say, oh, I agree, but not very many people are down to make a difference on that. They're not ready to make an impact on that. So when I got this following and these people started backing me and pushing me with the Mile High Square Body Club, I decided, you know what, time to make a difference in the community. I have a following of people, I have a small network of people, these are great people. And we did it last year, man, and it wasn't a lot of cars. I mean, we had maybe 8 square body trucks out here, but the amount of volume of donations that we had was overwhelming. Like, I couldn't believe 8 of the homies in my raggedy ass truck club brought out that much food because they had all recognized they'd been in hard times and they all wanted to help make a difference in those hard times for other people. Because it seems like two types of people in this world. You get hurt, you get down on your luck. Well, there's that old saying, hurt people will hurt people. And that's how you create a cycle. But then you see those people that have been down on their luck and they never forget that. They never forget what it was like, and they never forgot that feeling and how much it sucked. And those are the kind of people that revert that feeling. They wanted to not ever feel like that again, so they want to help other people not have to go through that to begin with. And so that, to me, is the whole point behind this, is just to make it where everybody can get something to eat, everybody's got a full stomach, and we're breaking that cycle. We're a lot of guys that are out here trying to break that cycle. There's people out here in different communities. It seems like we don't get a lot of support from government to begin with. You have to make a certain amount. Well, that's, in my opinion, why government doesn't work. And I don't want to get into a political spiel or anything like that, but we're just trying to fill that void. We're trying to close that gap for the people in our community to give back to our community, because we don't want to see all the people that fall through the crack on a regular basis. I mean, there's tons of people that go hungry every year and it's not even Thanksgiving. So if maybe the one dude goes to the food bank and he hasn't eaten in days, and that dude really truly has something to be thankful for this year because he had a full stomach, And whether that came from us or whether it came from somewhere else, however he got it is the whole point behind it. But if we can make a difference in that impact, then that's what we're here for. We don't forget where we came from. We don't forget the struggle. Hell, a lot of us still do struggle, you know what I mean? But we know that struggle. We fucking feed on that struggle. We dig deep and make the best outcome possible from that struggle. And so that being said, it comes down to one or two people. You could be the guy that's, oh, well, you know what? I've been hungry. Nobody helped me. Why should I give a fuck? Well, that's great, man. That's what we call a cycle. We're out here to break that fucking cycle. We want to make sure everybody gets something to eat this year. We want to make sure that everybody has a good time this year. And this video really is just to try to promote that. Yeah, my truck club is the one hosting the event. That's great. But we're inviting everybody out. We don't want just people in the truck club. If you got a little bit of food and you're not using it in your pantry, come out. Give it to us, man. We'll put it in the right hands. Because that shit that's been sitting on your shelf for a year that you're not eating, somebody would love to have that right now. They would love to eat that right this minute. And we want to put it in the right hands.